Okay, we'll continue on the solving the problems on steam. So these steam tables based on saturation pressure and saturation temperature and the TH diagram. So already we have solved one problem on this, and now we move on to the second problem. Determine the conditions of steam from the following data. Pressure is 10 bar and temperature 200 degree Celsius. So under the first condition is the steam pressure is 10 bar and temperature is 200 degree Celsius. And another condition, pressure is 12 bar and enthalpy up 2600 kilojoules per kg. So here the pressure and the temperature, in the first case the temperature is given, we have to determine the conditions. What is the condition of steam, whether it is a wet steam or dry steam or whether it is a superheated steam. So that we must determine. Then in the second case, pressure is 12 bar and enthalpy of 2600 kilojoules per kg. So again we need to determine condition of the steam. So this is the slide giving the solution. So in the top, again the problem is mentioned once again here. So for the first statement, so the pressure, the steam pressure is 10 bar and temperature is 200 degree Celsius. From the steam tables, at the pressure of 10 bar, what is the saturation temperature we must take? So that is, here it is taken as 179.88. so slightly the fraction may be varying. Just we see for the 10 bar, what is the 10 bar at 10 bar, the pressure is 179.84 degree Celsius. Okay, here once 179.88, so slight the fractional variation. Okay, since the saturation temperature, it is 179.88 degree Celsius at the 10 bar, it is less than the given steam temperature. The given steam temperature is 200 degree Celsius. Given in the problem statement, if you see that pressure is 10 bar and temperature 200 degree Celsius, so that means saturation temperature is less than the steam temperature of the 200 degree Celsius. So the steam saturation temperature is 200, so that's why we can say under this condition the steam is stated to be as a superheated steam. And for the superheated steam, to how much extent this steam is superheated, that is the degree of superheat. Degree of superheat, it can be calculated by the difference between the superheat temperature and saturation temperature. So T superheat minus T saturation, so that is 200 minus 179.88. so this will give the degree of superheat as 20.12 degree Celsius. Okay, next the part B of the problem, the condition of the steam we have to tell. And the pressure of steam is 12 bar and enthalpy is 2600 kilojoules per kg. From the steam table, at 12 bar we have to take the data, that is enthalpy, HF and HFG, So if you take for 12 bar, if you take for the 12 bar pressure, 187.92 is the saturation temperature. Next 2 columns are specific enthalpy, specific volume, and next 798.1 is HF, 1984.5 is HFG for 12 bar. So 7 slight variation in fraction. HF is 798.43, it is taken here. HFG is 1984.27. So here HG is nothing but summing this HF and HFG. HG is nothing but sum of HF and HFG, that is HG. So here HG means what is the enthalpy of the steam when it is at the point C. When it is at the point C, the enthalpy is HG. So that is HG is 2782.7 kilojoules per kg. Since the value of enthalpy of the steam HG is greater than the given enthalpy, that is 2600 kilojoules per kg. So that means the given value of enthalpy of the steam HG is greater than the given enthalpy of 2600 kilojoules per kg. So by this we can understand still the steam is a wet steam. So what is the enthalpy of the wet steam? We can calculate from the formula H, that is the enthalpy of the wet steam, or H or HX we can say, that is equal to HF plus X into HFG. So that is substituting the enthalpy as 2600 and HF as 798.43, plus X we have to calculate, substitute HFG 1984.27. So from this we can get the value of X, that is the dryness fraction. X is given, it comes about 0.908. This is in order to know the condition of the steam. Okay, if it is a superheated steam, we are calculating what is the degree of superheat. If it is a wet steam, we are calculating the dryness fraction of the steam. So then we'll move to the next problem, one more problem. It states that given enthalpy of 1 kg of steam at 30 bar is 3681 kilojoules. Okay, is the steam is wet or superheated? So that means given enthalpy of 1 kg of steam at 30 bar pressure is 3681, enthalpy is 3681 kilojoules. Okay, is the steam is wet or superheated? We need to first identify this. If it is wet, find the dryness fraction. If it is superheated, find its degree of superheat. Again, assume the specific heat of superheated steam as 2.25 kilojoules per kg. Okay, so here again, referring the problem, the pressure of the steam is given as 30 bar. So for 30 bar pressure from the steam table, the values are taken as the saturation temperature is 233.8 degrees Celsius, and enthalpy HF is 1008.3 kilojoules per kg, HFG is 1794 kilojoules per kg. And from this summing HFG and HF, we get HG, that is 2802.3 kilojoules per kg. here, but the given enthalpy of the steam, given enthalpy of the steam is 3681 kilojoules per kg. It is greater than enthalpy of dry saturated steam, that is 2802. So given enthalpy of the steam is 3681, so it is greater than that of dry saturated steam. So that means this infers that the steam is superheated, because the enthalpy of the given steam is higher than the dry saturated steam. Okay, so that's why the steam condition, it is a superheated steam. Then we have to find the superheat temperature for this steam. So it is given by H superheat is equal to Hg plus Cp. Sorry, it is a, there is a, some mistake. Cp, it should be Cp into bracket T superheat minus T saturation. So substituting these the data, so H superheat, that is enthalpy of the superheated stream, is 3681, and Hg is 2802.4, Cp is 2.25 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Then T superheat we have to identify, we have to find minus 233.8, that is saturation temperature. So from the calculation we get the superheat temperature is equal to 309.53 degrees Celsius, and this is the superheat temperature. Okay, and similarly if we calculate the degree of superheat, that is difference between superheat temperature and the saturation temperature, that is T superheat minus TS, okay, that is degree of superheat, that is equal to 156.73. okay, so this is about the solution of for the problem number 3. Okay, so we'll continue. Until then, thank you.